It's not what happens to us or around us that determines how successful and how happy we're going to be. It's what we do about what happens is what makes the difference. It's the choices we make that makes the difference, the actions that we take that makes the difference. It's the thoughts that we have about the challenge that formulate the beliefs that we have about the challenge that makes the difference. It's what you're concentrating on and focusing on 24/7 that makes the difference. It's the word you're speaking out loud every single day that makes the difference. And do you have the courage to enjoy yourself during the process? And are you going to dare yourself to find the laughter in between the tough times? I believe each and every one of us in this room, every one of you, has an abundance of optimism within you somewhere. The things that I just mentioned are the tools that you need to drill for that optimism. Hey man, I could only give you the tools. It's up to you as to whether you use them or not. Children are the funniest people on the face of this planet. Doesn't matter how old they are, 2 years old, preteens, whew, that's a category. Preteens are like old people. You tell them what to do, they walk away and they mumble. They do. You actually hear them walking away going, I didn't even do nothing. What are you picking on me for? I got to do everything all the time. I'm the owner. This place is just like living in a prison. What are you saying? Nothing. God, can't even breathe. What a good group. Hey, you know what I always wanted to do? I haven't done this yet, but I promise you someday I will do this. It just takes a lot of nerve. I always wanted to get pulled over by a cop, roll down the window and go, you're not going to check the trunk, are you? How much better do you feel right now that you're laughing? How much better do you feel right now?
After leaving a successful career as a stand-up comedian, headlining comedy clubs and big stage networks, Steve Rizzo transitioned his life at the pinnacle of his comedy career into a huge success as a Hall of Fame professional speaker. This seriously funny guy has mastered the art of education and entertainment for corporate audiences worldwide.
When I first met him, he was a stand-up comic, and now he's a speaker who's been inspiring people all over the world.
Let me tell you the real reason why I'm here. I'm here because I need the money. I'm here very simply to show you all how to acquire and maintain this very special attitude that you need to continue the success that you are now achieving, and even how to kick it up a couple of notches so you can get to that next level while enjoying the process. Listen to me, my friends. There within lies the key phrase, while enjoying the process. Why is it the key phrase? Because it seems to be something that most people leave by the wayside, especially when we're setting out to achieve our goals, when we want to accomplish something, when we're pushing ourselves to get to that next level, to raise the bar. That's when the stress level can get really intense. Self-doubt, overwhelm, fear, anger can become very dangerous mindsets. And without you ever realizing it, enjoying yourself becomes secondary. And with what you do for a living, with the responsibility that you have, with the position that you have, that's when it has to become primary. Studies have shown that people who make conscious choices to enjoy themselves during the process of whatever it is they're trying to achieve are more creative, more productive, they're able to bounce back a lot faster from life's challenges, and they're able to find solutions to problems a lot quicker. Whenever you are in the middle of a negative emotion of any kind, at some point you literally have to stop yourself and say, whoa, where is this going to take me? If you don't like the answer, know that you have the power to change the outcome. So when I'm in traffic and I think I'm going to lose it, I do something completely out of the ordinary to step myself out of it, and I do this. I turn into the lion from The Wizard of Oz. I figure it's going to be hours before I get home, so what the heck, I'm going to have fun. Everyone else is angry, their blood pressure's going high, they're beeping the horns, they're cursing at each other. Watch them, it's insane out there, not me. If you ever look at me in traffic, I'm looking right back going... I want to go home. I want to go home. Oh, you laugh, people in the next car are going, don't look at him and he won't say anything.
got a New York license plate. Lock the door. Look straight ahead. Don't look at him. Don't look at him.
See, you might think I'm crazy, and so might everyone else that's in traffic, but here's the point, and a very important point. At least I know I'm not going to work in a bad mood. I'm not meeting with a client in a bad mood. I'm not going home in a bad mood. As a matter of fact, my friends, you want to know what? No matter where it is that I am going, no matter what it is that I am doing, I am going there, and I am doing it in a really good mood. My energy level is cranked. It's up here instead of down here. Do you want to know why? Basic psychology. I was able to change my state of mind. I did this all by myself. I was able to go from a potentially bad mood to a good mood just by getting in tune with my humor being. Understand this. Your sense of humor is your sense of perspective. It's a choice we all have on how to deal with so much of the stuff that life throws at us every day.